Will you please stand to sing our first hymn, Be Thou My Vision?
Jesus Christ be with you. It's so good to be with you this evening. What a joyous occasion to be at. This is the first time I've been in church when we've been able to sing. Gosh, it's amazing, isn't it? You suddenly realise what we've missed all this time, but to be able to give praise to God. So it's highly appropriate this evening, Hayley, that we can actually join in that sense of singing together and praising God. It just adds to the celebration. We have come together in the presence of God to celebrate with Hayley her life and ministry, to license her to the ministry she will share, to pray for Hayley and for those who minister with her, and to dedicate ourselves afresh to the service of God in this community and to the call which God makes of each one of us. Heavenly Father, we gather in your name in thankfulness and praise for the continuing ministry of your church in this place, for all who have been raised up in times past to serve you here, and for your servant, Hayley, called by you to this present task. Guide and strengthen all your faithful people, that we may give ourselves in love and service to one another and to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Do sit for our reading.
reading is taken from Mark chapter 1, verses 16 to 20. As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
This is a relatively short passage in Scripture, just some really simple sentences describing a story of Jesus walking along by the lakeside and calling out to those first men who he says, "Come and follow me." Really simple story. You can imagine the pictures, the artists painting, the fishermen in their boats, and Jesus walking along. The kind of story we tell our children. But there is so much in this passage that speaks to us about who Jesus is and how he calls us and how he speaks to us and says, "Come and follow me." I love the fact that Jesus makes relevance to the people he is speaking to. So he knows he's speaking to some fishermen. And so he uses the language of fishermen. "I'm going to make you fishers of people. You've been out catching fish, and now you're going to catch people." He makes it relevant to who they are, and he understands the context in which he comes and calls them. And there must be something amazing about Jesus that they see immediately. I don't know whether they've heard of him up until now, whether they've heard stories of this man who's suddenly arrived in town and is teaching people, whether they know anything, or whether this is the first encounter of Jesus. But regardless of what they know, their response is dramatic. They leave everything to follow him. So there is something relevant in what they're hearing. There's something attractive. There's something compelling that says, "Yes, this is something I want to do. I want to leave what I know, what I'm comfortable with, and I want to follow this man." And Jesus only says, "Come and follow me." He doesn't say, "Come and follow me for 3 years." He doesn't say, "Come and follow me for the rest of your life, and we're going to go here, there, and the next place." And so often when Jesus calls, we just get that first part. We just get that sense that he's saying something to us. It might be that first invitation to come to know him for ourselves for the very first time. "Come. Come and find out who I am. Come and experience the love I have for you. Come and let me show you the Father." Or it might be that he's saying, "Come, I've got some jobs for you today." It might be being ordained, like Hayley. It might be to leave where she's been and come to a place where actually you have some idea of what it's going to look like. But God hasn't told you exactly, and Ian probably hasn't told you exactly what it's going to look like. Because the call is the first part, and the journey of discovery of what that call looks like is colored in as we go along. Jesus comes and he calls these fishermen. He says, "Come and follow me," and they respond because they've understood what he's saying. It's been relevant to them. And even though they don't know exactly what it's going to look like, they say, "Yes, we want to follow." And so they follow. And this is just one of the first episodes of Jesus calling his disciples. We know that there are 12 that he calls, and each one of them is different. These first four happen all to be fishermen. But he calls others who are very, very different. Matthew the tax collector. He calls people who are who they are themselves, And he brings them together because as God's family, as God's congregations, as God's people, we all need to be who we are, but we also need those who are not like us too. And that's the joy of God's call as well, that he calls us to work together. So Hayley, you come to join a team where you come as yourself. You will change as you grow and develop in this place, and others will be changed by you being here. But don't lose sight of who you are. God has called you for who you are, and he's called the rest of the team to be who they are. And you will have different gifts, different strengths. And you're called to be a team, not to do everything yourselves, but you've got this crowd of people as well, who are all called to the mission that God has for you as a people in this place. What does that look like? Who do you need to be? What do you need to do? What do you need to invest in? What are the priorities? I'm sure you've done some mission planning because all churches have done. But being alert to what God is saying at any given time is listening for his call and listening to say, I know who you are. I know your situation. I know you're struggling with all these restrictions post-COVID and you don't quite know what it's going to look like. I understand that. And yet, if you listen to me, I will guide you. I will guide you and show you the people that you need to be with. The neighbors who are really struggling because they're fearful of what lies ahead. And something in who you are and the light that you display will show them that they too can sense the presence and the peace of Jesus with them. God knows us. He knows exactly who we are. He calls us whoever we are, as we are. We grow, we change, we develop as the Spirit does a work within us. And he calls us to work with others, to do his work. I love that obedience of these first disciples. They probably hadn't a clue what they were letting themselves in for, but isn't that wonderful? You say yes, and then the rest follows into place. But they said yes. And Hayley, you have said yes to God's call. I've met with you and heard you say, I just think God is saying something different for this stage of my life. I just think it might be Chandlers Ford. And so we go on a journey of exploration. And tonight is a joy because you have said yes and God has made it clear that this is where you are to be. But the rest is yet to come. But we know that God will show you. And as you work with the team and as you work as a people gathered here, God will continue to show you who you are, who you need to be, and where he wants you to go. Come and follow me, he says. Follow me and I will take you to those places. I will take you to those people. And they too will say yes. Yes, I will follow Jesus. Amen.
Bishop, I bring greetings from Hedgen St. Luke's, where Hayley has been ministering until now. We wish Hayley well in this new ministry to which she has been called. We pray that the parish, the community, and the diocese will be enriched by her presence, and that Hayley will be greatly blessed in her life here.
I thank you for your commendation and for the prayer with which it comes. Thank you.
Bishop, after prayerful consideration and due consultation, Hayley has been nominated and accepted to be associate priest of this parish. I now present her to you to be licensed.
I thank you for this presentation and I will gladly admit her. And now I invite the area dean to confirm that Hayley has taken the necessary oaths and made the declaration of assent.
She has duly taken the oath of allegiance to the sovereign and the oath of canonical obedience to the bishop. She has affirmed and declared her belief in the faith which is revealed in the Holy Scriptures and set forth in the Catholic creeds, and to which the historic formularies of the Church of England bear witness.
Hayley, I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and welcome you to this parish. Do you believe that God has called you to serve in this parish as associate priest?
I do so believe.
People of God, is it your will that Hayley should serve with you in this place?
Yes.
Will you support and uphold her in this ministry? The care of the people of a parish is a solemn trust. I therefore call upon you now to pray to God for Hayley, for this parish, and for yourselves. As the song is sung, do pray for Hayley. We praise you, God our Father, for the work of the Spirit in your church. Pour down your blessing on your people and give to your servant Hayley the gifts of grace she needs faithfully to fulfill the ministry to which she has been called, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I, Deborah, Bishop of Southampton, delegate for this purpose of the Bishop of Winchester, to my beloved in Christ, Hayley Jane Richens, Clerk in Holy Orders, greetings. I do hereby give and grant to you my license and authority to serve as an associate priest in the benefice of Chandlers Ford within the diocese and jurisdiction of the Lord Bishop of Winchester, under the direction of the incumbent or priest in charge thereof, and to perform all ecclesiastical duties belonging to the said office. In testimony whereof, I have hereunto set my hand, and the episcopal seal of the Bishop of Winchester is hereunto affixed, this 20th day of July, in the year of our Lord, 2021. Hayley, receive this ministry, which is both mine and yours, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hayley, may God give you the spirit of holy discipline, of faithfulness and of love for all his people, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Congregation, stay seated, and Hayley and others are going up to the altar rail.
To equip and sustain you in your ministry.
Jesus commanded his followers to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Will you, by your teaching and example, lead out the church in mission, making and baptizing disciples, and encouraging all to respond to the call of God?
With the help of God, I will. Will you share with me in the mission of Jesus in this community?
We will. Hayley, as a leader and teacher of God's people, you must be diligent in prayer and in study of the scriptures, that you may hear and respond to the voice of Christ. Will you do this?
With the help of God, I will. Will you share with me in the regular study and proclamation of God's word, that together we may bring light into darkness?
With the help of God, we will. Hayley, it is your duty and privilege to preside at the Holy Communion, declaring the death and resurrection of Jesus and uniting his people in love. Will you do this?
With the help of God, I will. Will you share regularly with me in Holy Communion that we may grow in unity and love and together proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes?
With the help of God, we will.
Priests are called by God to work with the bishop and their fellow priests as servants and shepherds among the people to whom they are sent. Hayley and the other priests and ministers of this deanery, will you work with your colleagues in this chapter to further Christ's work in this area and witness to the unity to which we are called?
With the help of God, we will.
Could I invite those who are also in the congregation tonight, who are involved in the leadership of this parish, please to stand.
What?
Eternal God, the light of the minds that know you, the joy of the hearts that love you, and the strength of the wills that serve you, grant us so to know you that we may truly love you, and so to love you that we may truly serve you, whom to serve is perfect freedom, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, who has given you the will to undertake this ministry together, give you also grace and strength to perform it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
People of this parish, I present to you Hayley, your new priest. Love her and pray for her. I invite you to greet her in the name of Christ. We welcome you. May the Lord bless you and make you a blessing among us. Stand. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let us offer one another a COVID cautious sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
If you'd like to sit for our prayers. Let us pray to God through Christ, who is our light and life. For our fellowship in Christ, for all who live and worship in this parish, for the Diocese of Winchester, and for Tim, Debbie, and David, our bishops, that Christ's people may grow in unity and in commitment to the Church's mission. Lord of the Church, in your mercy, hear us. For the communities in which we live, for our civic leaders in parish and city, and for all who serve through voluntary agencies, that our common life may be renewed in justice and peace. Lord of the world, in your mercy, hear us. For the poor, the lonely, and the bereaved, for any who are in danger, sorrow, or trouble, for all who are ill, and those who care for them, that they may find comfort, strength, and hope. Lord of compassion, in your mercy, hear us. For the young people of this parish, the schools and playgroups, the parents, the teachers, and school governors, that we may learn from each other and all grow as children of God, Lord of our growth, in your mercy, hear us. Rejoicing in our Christian inheritance and thankful for those who have gone before us in faith, let us pray that we may all be faithful in building up the body of Christ in the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. Lord of the ages, In your mercy, hear us. Rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Well, it's lovely to see old faces as well as new faces, those that are here to support me, thank you, from the Salvation Army, from St Luke's, from St Andrew's, from further afield, I do really thank you. But to those at Chandlers Ford, I can't wait to get to know you, and I hope you're going to get to know me real soon. So this isn't a one-off event, I'm back on Sunday. Please do come on Sunday for my first sermon. Come and ask me any questions you may have. I'm quite happy to answer anything you may have to ask me. And then next Wednesday at 10 o'clock again, please do come to St. Martin's in the Wood, where I'll be presiding for my first Holy Communion in this parish. So thank you for the welcome, and let's get to know each other real soon. Thank you. So we've got a great song to end with. I hope you've got good voice left. We've enjoyed singing this evening, haven't we? Please do stand and sing these wonderful words. Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord?
I'm not afraid to die.
has called you is faithful. The Father, whose glory fills the heavens, cleanse you by his holiness and send you to proclaim his word. Amen.
Amen.
Christ, who has ascended to the heights, pour upon you the riches of his grace. Amen.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit, the Comforter, equip you and strengthen you in your ministry. Amen.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen. Go in the power of Christ. We have a gospel to proclaim. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.